cake up all over his face. Well, he'll have his chance, but so will Stacey Blitz first. She's got the sunglasses, she's got the cornrows, she started this whole thing. She was helping Denise loading up off the track last time out in Shea Brown. Let's see if she tries to pace herself for that match race against Mark Webber. She says, I now am the captain of the Hot Dice. Hear me roar.
We might see the women in this game helping each other up as well. Shea Brown and Stacey Blitz going against one another, but at halftime it'll be very interesting, won't it? You would think that a man would have the advantage against a woman one-on-one in a match race, but who knows? We'll see. There's a little Jamie Conomac. She has the advantage as she knocks down Crystal Schneider. And that leaves the Quakes with the only two jammers out there right now with a chance to score points, led by little Jamie Conomac. Well, she's turned into a great skater and just as good almost. Maybe is just as good. Jennifer Matthews just a few strides behind her. They have a chance to rack up some points. Shea Brown is back to block. And Stacey Blitz, with that motorcycle helmet on, whispers to her teammates and says, here's what we're going to do. Let's see how it plays out. Conomac grabs the hand, and there's that leg whip. That sends both Conomac and Matthews through.
Two blue.
Good play.
Let's
two
go, let's quick go. Crank it up, crank it up.
Shea Brown didn't need anybody to help
him.
Is you all right?
Well, I guess we're seeing more of the same. We already saw Stacey Blitz helping Denise loading up after a tough shot a couple times last game. She's doing the same to Shea Brown. Knocks her down, helps her up.
2-0, Quakes leading. At the top of the show, when I looked down there at the Hot Dice women, I saw Courtney Barlow, all of a sudden a member of the Hot Dice. You remember she was in that leather outfit for the Enforcers for so long. She was one of the women that was ordered off the track by Mark D'Amato and the New York Enforcers. And then, when it came time to put that team back together, Courtney Barlow said, that's it. I've had enough of D'Amato. I don't want to go back. And as a free agent, she signed with the Hot Dice. So that helps their team, and there she goes. She still has the black leather pants, although she's changed her top a little bit. And she's on the jam now for the Hot Dice. And down she goes. Well, that's all right, though, because she's a great jammer, and she'll help this team immeasurably.
And she looks great.
Stacey Blitz takes care of Linda Morgan as well. Morgan's a little slow to get up. So Stacey Blitz now against Shea Brown. They've been shaking hands and patting each other on the back. When it's time for the game, they've been all business so far, and that's what's happening right now. Shea Brown rips her twice, three times with that elbow. Stacey tried to sneak by on the lower part of the track. It didn't work, and Shea Brown takes her out. Wow, really knocked her down hard.
And once again, Rory, we're seeing a...
No score on the play.
Stereotypical play on the track. We always do, but that's something we don't
let's
always
go,
see.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Stacey Blitz goes down at the hands of Shea Brown, payback for last jam, but instead of going after, I mean, we'd have had what, Rory, by now? 2 or 3, 4 or 5 or 27 fights? By now we've had none.
Nobody's gone after Shea Brown in the least, and I have a few women might be saying, well, that's kind of safe for her because she'll need all of that energy and talent when she gets out there against Mark Webber in that match race. We'll have that at halftime for you. So far, the Quakes are the only team on the scoreboard. We were talking about Courtney Barlow a minute ago. Let's see if she can get through here. Jennifer Matthews and Christine Cossin jamming for the Quakes. 2-0. The Quakes have the lead in the game. Barlow takes care of one of them. Now she has Matthews and knocks her flat. I told you Courtney Barlow would be a great addition to this team. And Shea Brown wants to help her through the pack, knocks Cindy Zimmerman out of there. And Brown is running the interference, Bonilla goes down. Now all that's left is Blitz, and she's into the rail. Barlow got them all, thanks to Shea Brown. She picked up each and every one of them.
Play. Total 3 white.
Rory, I don't think she's rested for that match race. I think she's trying to get warmed up for it. We saw last champ, she took down Stacey Blitz, the reigning leader of the Bob Squad and the women's movement. Well, heck, with her down, she just went through the rest of the Bob Squad like mincemeat.
They gave her 3 points. You know, we've seen Shea Brown in the past with her hair wild, her eyes wide open, screaming, yelling, fighting, pulling hair. In this game, she's been sedate by comparison.
Well, that was on the team bus when she was doing odd stuff, Rory. It really got ugly once she put the uniform on. Or lack of uniform on, as it were, with that little black thing she's wearing.
I really think they're just kind of saving her up for that match race. Webber must outweigh her by at least 50 pounds. Let's see what happens on this jam. Stacey Blitz and time to shave around, get out there. Kanamak is trailing. Blitz bumps Brown. So far, still no real hard contact. Now Stacy Blitz goes down, and Kanamak is left to take on Shay Brown by herself. Shay Brown and Jamie Kanamak in this final jam of the first period. The first period is the women's period, and the men will be on the track. A little bump again for Kanamak. Brown wants to be captain of this team. Weber's been the captain for a long time. Kanamak goes down. And now Stacy Blitz, back to block, turns around to face her nemesis. Wasn't much of a hit, was it? Brown goes down, but it really wasn't all that hard.
No score.
No points on the jam for either side.
And I'm wondering how long this alliance can hold, Murray. You know, these girls are really competitive. They go against each other. It's easy to be antagonized by Mark D'Amato and Mark Weber off the track. But once you get out here, the competition, the blood starts to boil. I don't know. I look for a crack in this alliance pretty soon. And look at the plays like that. It's not going to take long.
That's the end of the first period. 3-2, hot dice to Mariners.